It always ends with no negative comments, please. And then a few people will say, you're doing great, mama. And that one mom will be like, you know, there is a great essential oil for that. I'm not even a mom, and yet I know the culture. I was horrified when I saw the decor at Ben and Jen's wedding. We finally know what President Donald Trump wrote in the letter he left for President Biden when he left office, and it's definitely shocking. It looks like Brad and Angelina's marriage falling apart can be blamed on them mostly letting their kids rule their house. And we have a jam-packed Hot Take Tuesday with even more stories. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Jennifer Lopez was possessed by the ghost of a Midwest Facebook mom or something. The theme of the highly anticipated Ben Affleck JLo wedding was allegedly supposed to be old Hollywood, but parts of it are giving reckless Etsy. Have you seen some of the pictures? The live, laugh, love vibes of this wedding are off the charts. Like, what happened? Girl who is the literal wedding planner commit wedding suicide like this. This just proves that you can be rich and still have terrible style. Okay, speaking of JLo, remember this gem from Shepard Smith on Fox News? I cannot believe this is a real thing that happened.
JLo's new song, Jenny from the Block, all about Lopez roots, about how she's still a neighborhood gal at heart. But folks from that street in New York, the Bronx section, sound more likely to give her a curb job than a blowjob or block party. The New York Post, we're sorry about that slip up there. I have no idea how that happened. But it won't happen again. And that's your news.
Everyone knows it's tradition for an outgoing president to leave the incoming president a letter wishing them luck or giving advice. And after the 2020 election, there was a lot of speculation if Trump would leave President Biden a letter or not. And if he did, what would it say? A lot of people assumed Trump would say something savage, but we never got an answer until now.
What do you think is Joe Biden's strongest feature as a competitor in politics?
Well, I would have said experience, but he doesn't really have experience because I don't think he remembers what he did yesterday. So how is that experience? He's been there a long time. He was never known as a smart person.
Pick one good thing. Okay, what is his weakest point?
I can't tell you. I mean, I'm really serious. He's got many. I could talk about weak points all day long. First of all, he's not mentally sharp enough to be president. He's got China, he's got all these countries, Russia. I've been the worst thing that ever happened to Russia. Putin understands that. I get along with Putin, but he understands that. He probably doesn't want me to win, I can tell you right now. Except I think he likes me, but I'm sure he doesn't want me to win. China doesn't want me to win, but Biden doesn't know. I mean, he doesn't know he's alive.
According to the Daily Mail, Trump did leave behind the traditional presidential letter for President Biden. And after President Biden read it, he commented to an aide that he was surprised by the graciousness of it. It hasn't been revealed what the letter said, but even I have to admit, I'm pretty shocked if the letter was kind. I don't think I was expecting that.
Unless he gets a lot smarter, a lot quicker.
So, Mr. President?
Did you use the word smart? So you said you went to Delaware State, but you forgot the name of your college. You didn't go to Delaware State. You graduated either the lowest or almost the lowest in your class. Don't ever use the word smart with me. Don't ever use that word.
Oh, give me a
break. Because you know what? There's nothing smart about you, Joe.
Insiders are spilling that what really led to the demise of Brad Pitt and Angelina's marriage was letting their kids rule the roost. In fact, they allege it was so bad, it caused multiple nannies to quit. Now, I love kids, but you'd have to pay me a lot of money to babysit for some Hollywood elites. Towards the end of their relationship, apparently Brad and Angelina slept in separate rooms and Angelina moved her brother in to help with the kids. Yes, the same brother she made out with. It's always the ones they tell you not to worry about.
I'm so in love with my brother right now. He just held me and said he loved me and I know he's so happy for me. And thank you for that. And
we still have a lot more stories to get through, so good thing it's Tuesday.
Hot Take Tuesday.
LGB Drop the T has been trending on Twitter and gaining traction as the lesbians, gays, and bisexuals say that trans people should be in their own category because they're too radical and ruining things for everyone else. You don't say.
Excuse me, it's ma'am. It is ma'am.
Piers Morgan made fun of Gwyneth Paltrow for saying phrases like penis-bearing people and people with a prostate on Goop social media posts instead of the word men. Maybe she's just trying out new names for her upcoming candles.
You done lost your damn mind. When you get your damn mind, you call me.
After Hurricane Katrina, Brad Pitt wanted to prove that eco-friendly homes could be built in an affordable fashion. So he had a bunch of homes built in the Ninth Ward for Katrina survivors. Only problem, they completely fell apart. Like they were junk. Electrical issues, mold, all sorts of disasters. And he was just forced to settle for $20.5 million. The Green New Bad Deal.
And they need to be destroyed.
In a new Rolling Stone interview, Harry Styles said he was gutted to be missing the new season of Love Island while he's touring. Now, producer Valentina is obsessed with Love Island UK. Anyone else?
I'm not sat on the yellow one. I'm scared of that yellow beanbag.
Anyone who sits on it, you get drama.
I did watch the Manti Te'o two-part documentary on Netflix, and yes, it was excellent. I did not pay attention to the story when it went down. I bet it was because it had something to do with sports, and so like when it happened, I just tuned it out, you know, to be completely honest, but what a heartbreaking story. We said, ew, Manti Te'o. Like and thumbs up this episode. Do you like Bennifer's wedding decor? Are you old enough to remember Angelina Jolie making out with her brother? And what do you think Trump wrote in that letter to President Biden? Send this episode to a friend who's always complaining about psychos in their mom Facebook groups and then tap the save button. POPlitics is back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark and this is POPlitics. Clearly, POPlitics is best served visually, but you can also listen to POPlitics if you just want the audio. Subscribe to us anywhere you get your podcasts, Apple, Spotify, iHeart, TuneIn, and more. Also, make sure that if you are listening to the podcast version, you leave us a 5-star review. And don't forget, subscribe to POPlitics on YouTube.